What's up internet, welcome back once again. I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and this is the third tutorial in how to create Tablespace series. Today in this tutorial, I will show you how to create an undo tablespace. Undo tablespace is kind of permanent tablespace used by Oracle Database Engine to manage undo data if you are running your database in automatic undo management mode. This undo data or say undo records are generally used to rollback transaction when a rollback statement is issued. Recover the database, provide read consistency, analyze data as of an early point in the time by using Oracle Flashback Query, recover from logical corruption using Oracle Flashback feature. Similar to other two tablespaces, for example permanent and temporary tablespace which we have discussed in the previous tutorial, undo tablespace can also be created as a small file as well as big file tablespace. By the way, if you haven't watched my previous two tutorials, then find the link in the description box. Okay. So let's move ahead and see how to create an undo tablespace in Oracle Database. As we are creating an undo tablespace, thus we will use create undo tablespace clause. First, let me write create undo tablespace clause, then I will explain it to you along with the restriction of undo tablespaces. So let's write the clause. Here, the create undo tablespace statement is slightly different than those that we have done so far. So let's dig into this statement and see what we have done here. The first line is self-explanatory. Here we are creating a small file undo tablespace by the name of tbsp_undo. In the second line, we have our data file clause using which I have added a data file tbsp_undo.dbf to our undo tablespace which has an initial size of 100 MB. As it's a small file tablespace, that means we can add multiple data files into it, which is otherwise not possible in case of big file tablespace that can have maximum one data file only. For the simplicity of the demonstration, here I have added only one data file. In the third line, we have auto extend clause. Using this clause, we are ensuring that as soon as our data file tbsp_undo.dbf, which is of 100 MB size, get filled with undo segments, Oracle Engine will extend it automatically and increment it by 500 MB. In the fourth line, we have clause max size. Using this clause, we can set the maximum size to which the data file of our tablespace can extend or say grow. Here I have set the maximum size of our data file tbsp_undo.dbf to unlimited. You can also limit the max size of your data file. For that, simply write the size. For example, say you want to set the max size of your data file to 50 MB. In that case, simply write 50 MB in place of unlimited. Let's do it. See, that's all you have to do. In the fifth and the last line, we have retention clause, which is as of now set on no guarantee. You can set retention clause either on guarantee or no guarantee. Retention guarantee specifies that Oracle Database should preserve unexpired undo data in all undo segments of tablespace. This setting is useful if you need to issue an Oracle Flashback query or an Oracle Flashback transaction query to diagnose and correct a problem with the data. Retention no guarantee returns the undo behavior to normal. Space occupied by unexpired undo data in undo segments can be consumed if necessary by ongoing transaction, and this is the default. If you do not specify this clause, Oracle Engine by default set the retention on no guarantee. Every necessary setting is done. So let's execute this query. But on executing this query, we will get an error. So let's execute and see what will be the error. As you can see, here we have ORA 02494 error with saying that invalid or missing maximum file size in max size clause. This is because the value we have specified in max size is 50 MB, which is smaller than the value we have specified in size clause, which is 100 MB. To avoid these kind of error, either try to set the value of max size clause greater than the value of size clause or set the max size clause to unlimited. So let's do one thing, let's set the max size clause to unlimited. Okay, now let's try executing this query. But before that, let me close this script output. Now let's execute. As you can see, this time small file tablespace is created. See how easy it is. In case if you want to create a big file undo tablespace, and yes, we are allowed to create one, just replace this small file keyword with big file. And make sure you have added only one data file to your tablespace, as big file tablespace can have only one data file. So before winding up, let's take a look at some undo tablespace restrictions. First, you cannot create database objects in this tablespace as it's reserved for system managed undo data. Second, the only clause you can specify for an undo tablespace are the data file clause and the extend underscore management underscore clause to specify local extend management. Third, all undo tablespaces are created permanent, read write and in logging mode. Values for minimum extent and default storage are system generated. Fourth, you can create more than one undo tablespace, but only one of them can be active at any given time. That's it for today. Hope you enjoyed watching. Please hit the thumbs up button and keep me motivated for doing more such videos. Also, you can share this video on your social and help me in reaching out to more people. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. We'll see you soon with another video. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.